studied the Zener diode. Zener diode is a special junction diode, which is a heavily doped p-n junction diode, which is used as a voltage regulator. See, in the same manner, see, we will going to study some optoelectronic junction devices which are manufactured for various practical applications. Like, the light energy can be converted into electric energy, and electric energy can be converted into light energy. See, these optoelectronic junction devices, either they convert light energy into electric energy or electric energy into light energy. See, one of which is the photodiode. See, let us consider a photodiode. Photodiode is a p-n junction diode which converts the light energy into electric energy. Okay. See, the circuit symbol of a photodiode. So, this is the p-n junction diode. See, these inward arrows represent the incident radiation on the photodiode. So, photodiode is a p-n junction diode which converts the light energy into electric energy. See, let us draw a p-n junction diode. See, this is a p-n junction diode which has two semiconducting materials. One is p-type material, another one is n-type material. This is depletion region, this is p-type, this is n-type. See, let this semiconducting junction, p-n junction, is connected to battery so that it is in reverse bias. See, p-type connected to negative terminal of the battery and n-type connected to positive terminal of the battery through a resistance and a micro-ammeter. See, this is a micro-ammeter. A small current is produced. We can produce a small current using this photodiode. To measure this small current, we can use a micro-ammeter. See, this is battery, this is resistance. See, now what happens when a p-n junction diode is under reverse bias? See, when the p-n junction diode is under reverse bias, no majority charge carriers can cross the junction barrier, since the height of the potential barrier increases and width of the depletion region also increases. So, now the minority carriers, the electrons in p-type and holes in n-type, they accelerated towards the electric field. See, due to the reverse bias, there is a large electric field is developed in the junction. This electric field is high enough to pull the electrons from p side and holes from n side. So, due to the flow of these minority charge carriers through the p-n junction diode, produces a small current known as the reverse current or reverse saturation current. See, we can draw a graph of the current versus voltage. See, this is IV characteristics of the photodiode. This is current in milliampere. This is voltage in volts. This is zero. This is current I in microampere. See, when the diode is in reverse bias, see, as the reverse voltage increases, the reverse current also increases. See, this is a small current flows through the diode under reverse bias. This current is called reverse saturation current, and this current is also known as the dark current. See, this current is called the dark current. Okay. See, this is reverse bias voltage V. See, this current. So, what is dark current? See, what is dark current? A current, a reverse current flows through the diode under the reverse bias voltage. See, this small reverse current is called the dark current. When there is no light incident on the depletion region. See, now incident a radiation of energy h nu on the depletion layer. See, these are the radiations of energy h nu. When these radiations of light incident on the depletion region, the electron hole pairs are created. These electron hole pairs are separated by the electric field. See, the electrons move towards the N region and holes move towards the P region. Okay. See, due to the flow of these charge carriers, see, the electrons flows through the N type material and holes flows through the P type material. This produces a small current in the photodiode. This current is measured using microammeter. See, this is a small current produced using photodiode. See, when the external load is connected, the current flows through this external load. See, this current flows through the junction diode depends on the intensity of incident radiation. As the intensity increases, the current through the junction diode increases. See, the photodiode, as the intensity increases, the current through the diode increases. See, suppose this is current I1, this is current I2, and this is current I3. The current I3 greater than current I2 greater than current I1. So therefore, the current reverse current increases as the intensity of radiation increases. So we can increase the reverse current through the photodiode by increasing the intensity of the light incident on the photodiode. Okay. These photodiodes are used to detect the light fall on the photodiode. So hence, these diodes are used as light detector. So whether it may be visible light or invisible light, we can detect the light using the photodiode. And also we can measure the intensity of the incident light using photodiode, and we can use the photodiodes as the light switches. See, when the light is incident on the photodiode, the current flows through the diode and hence it is on state. When the light is no light incident on the diode, it is in off state, no current flows through the diode. So therefore, the photodiode can be used as a switch. Okay, right. See, let us study one more LED. So one more optical optoelectronic junction device known as LED. See, let us study light emitting diode. See, just we studied the photodiode, see, which works under reverse bias. See, this light emitting diode converts the electric energy into light energy. See, whereas the photodiode converts the light energy into electric energy. Okay. See, in the photodiode, the photodiode works under reverse bias, whereas the light emitting diode works under forward bias. See the circuit symbol of an LED. See, this is circuit symbol of an LED. So LED is a junction diode which converts the electric energy into light energy. See, let us draw an LED. See, this LED is nothing but a PN junction diode which has two types of semiconducting materials. One is P type, the another one is N type. This is the depletion region of the PN junction diode. This is P type material and this is N type material. See, these are the two metallic contacts on P type and N type. See, P type connected to the positive terminal of the battery and N type connected to the negative terminal of the battery.
through a series resistor. This is resistor, or this is battery, this is negative and this is positive terminal. Okay, see what are the majority charge carriers in p-type. See, the majority charge carriers are holes in p-type, and majority charge carriers are electrons in n-type. Okay, see, when a p-n junction diode is under forward bias, the majority charge carriers can flow from one type to another type. See, that is when the forward bias voltage is greater than the potential barrier voltage. So when the forward voltage is greater than the potential barrier voltage, then the majority charge carriers can flow from one type to another type. See, in case of n type, the electrons flows from the n type to p type, and the holes flows from p type to n type. Okay, see, the minority charge carriers are here, the minority charge carriers are electrons, here the minority charge carriers are holes. See, in this region the minority carriers concentration increases. See, due to increase in the minority charge carriers, the electrons and holes recombine each other. See, the electrons and holes recombine each other. Due to the recombination of electrons and holes, due to the recombination of the electrons with the holes, energy is released in the form of light. See, this is the light energy emitted from the light emitting diode. So therefore, when the light emitting diode is under forward bias, the electrons crosses from n region to p region, and holes, the majority charge carriers in p type, crosses from p to n region. So due to increase in the minority charge carriers near the junction, the electrons and holes recombine each other and produces the energy. So therefore, the electric energy here is converted into light energy. When the forward current increases, the intensity of light emitted from the diode also increases. See, the LEDs are designed so that they must emit the high intensity and a maximum intense light. Okay, these light emitting diodes are used in panel indicators, computers, TV remote controllers and burglar alarms. Okay, say, let us study one more optoelectronic junction device known as solar cell. See, solar cell is a device which converts the light energy into electric energy. See, previously we have studied the photodiode, the first optoelectronic junction device we studied, that is photodiode. Photodiode also converts the light energy into electric energy. In the same manner, the solar cell also produces the light energy into electric energy. The main difference between the solar cell and the photodiode is, the photodiode is works under reverse bias, whereas in case of solar cell, no bias voltage applied across the solar cell. Let us study solar cell. Solar cell is also a optoelectronic junction device, as that of as same as that of the light emitting diode and photodiode. Say, the solar cell converts the light energy, the solar energy, into electric energy. The main difference between solar cell and the photodiode, see, photodiode also converts the light energy into electric energy. The main difference is, the solar cell works under no bias voltage, whereas photodiode works under reverse bias voltage. Okay, see, let us see the construction and working of a solar cell. See, a solar cell is nothing but a p-n junction diode. See, it has p-type and n-type material. See, a n-type material is grown on a p-type material. See, this is the n-type material. It is about 0.3 micrometer, and this is p-type material. It is the about 300 micrometer. So the thickness of n-type is 0.3 micrometer, whereas the thickness of the p-type material is about 300 micrometer. This is the depletion region. Okay. See, the p-type, the back side of the p-type is provided with a metal contact. This is called the back contact. See, the solar cell looks like this. See, this is again the back contact. Okay, this is back contact. Okay. See, the front side of the solar cell provided with the metallic fingers. See, these are the metallic fingers for the front contact. See, these are the metallic fingers for front contact. This is the top surface of the solar cell. Okay, this is n-type material and this is p-type material. So these are the front side metallic fingers for the front contact, and this is metal for the back contact. Okay, see, when the light radiations are incident on the solar cell, see what happens when radiations incident on the solar cell. See, when light is incident on the junction diode, see, this is a solar cell. It has two materials. One is p-type material and n-type material. This is the depletion region. See, this solar cell is connected to a load resistor. See, when the light radiations incident on the solar cell, the electron hole pairs are generated. See, these electrons and hole pairs are separated due to the electric field at the junction. See, the electrons move toward the N region and the holes move toward the P region. So the electric field is in the direction such that the electrons move towards N region and the holes move toward P region. See, these electrons flows through the circuit, produces a small current in the circuit. See, when the solar cell is connected to a load resistor, the current, a small current, flows through the circuit. See, solar cells are used in street lamps. Solar cells are used in traffic signals, and solar cells are also used to store the electric energy when in particularly in remote sensing areas. See, these solar cells, the important thing is that for the fabrication of a solar cell, the following things must be noted. So those are, the solar cells are made up of a silicon material or gallium arsenide material. of band gap about 1 electron volt to 1.8 electron volt, and the availability of the raw material. So these are the things which are very important for the fabrication of the solar cell. See the I versus V characteristics of a solar cell. See, this is current I and this is voltage V. See this I versus V graph is in fourth quadrant, since the diode uses no bias voltage and the solar cell produces the same voltage through the load resistor. So it is called the open circuit voltage. This is called the short circuit current. See, this is open circuit voltage, and this is short circuit current. So this is about the solar cell. So solar cell converts the light energy into electric energy. See, solar cells are used in space vehicles, electronic equipments. Solar cells are used in street lamps. Solar cells are used in traffic signals. Even the solar cells are used in remote sensing areas where there is no electric power supply. So solar cells are used to convert the solar energy, a free energy available in nature. Using this free energy we can convert the electric energy. Okay, so let us study digital electronics and logic gates. See, digital electronics deals with the study of the logic gates. See, digital electronics is basically the branch of the electronics, see, which deals with the construction working of the logic gates. See, the logic gates are the basic building blocks of so many electronic equipments like computers, laptops, etc. Okay, see analog signal will be continuous like this. See, this is an analog signal. Okay, whereas the digital signal is in the form of square wave like this. This is digital signals. Okay, see, this is voltage V, this is time T, this is voltage V, and this is time T. Okay, this is the major distinction between the analog signal and the digital signal. See, the digital signals are the signals which have the waveform like this, the square waveform. See, the digital signals have only the two digits, that is, one is 0 and the another one is 1. That is, 0 can be known as off state or low, and 1 can be called as on state or high state. So therefore, a logic gate or any digital electronic device can perform using only the two digits. They can perform only on the data fed to a digital circuit in the form of the binary digits known as 0 and 1. So 0 means off state or low, and 1 means on state or high. Okay, see, this is the difference between the analog signal and the digital signal. See, let us study the logic gates. See, the logic gates, there are three basic logic gates. The first one is NOT gate. See, as I said, these logic gates are the building blocks of the various digital electronic devices. See, the first one is the NOT gate. See, the first one is the NOT gate. See, the digital logic gates. See, logic gate is a gate which performs certain logical operation. So such a digital gate is called a logic gate. See, the first logic gate is the NOT gate. So the first one is NOT gate. See the circuit symbol of the NOT gate. See, this is the circuit symbol of a NOT gate. Okay. See the truth table, which explains the input and output of a logic gate. See this NOT gate has only one input and one output. See, this is input and this is output. See, suppose we give, suppose this is A input and this is Y output. See, this is A input and this is Y output. See, suppose the input is 0 and the output is 1. That is, when the input is given here, the inverted output gives by the NOT gate. So the NOT gate inverts the input signal. See, suppose the input is 1, the output is 0. See, this is the truth table of a NOT gate. So NOT gate inverts the input signal. See, if you give low value as input, we will get high value as output. Or if you give high value as input, we will get low value as output. Okay. See, this is called NOT gate. See, the second one, AND gate. AND gate. See, the circuit symbol of AND gate. See, AND gate has two or more inputs. See, this is AND gates. See, this is input A and this is input B. This is output Y. See, this is output Y. Y is equal to A and B. See, it can be read as A and B. Okay. See, this type of equations are called Boolean expressions. So this Boolean expressions gives the, which this Boolean expression gives the output of the AND gate, OR gate, NOT gate, etc. Okay. See, the truth table of AND gate. See, this is the truth table of AND gate. See, AND gate has two inputs and one output. This is Y output A and B. See, this is input A and this is input B. See, for the input 0, 0, if two, both the inputs are low, then we have the low output. Okay. So for both the inputs low, we get low output. See, suppose A is 0, B is 1. Okay. See, for low and high input, we will get the low output. And one more, see, for 1 and 0, we will get 0 output. And finally, for 1 and 1 input, for both the inputs high, see, when the both the inputs are high, we will get the output as high 1. So therefore, AND gate produces high output when its both the inputs are at high. Okay. Or the AND gate is on state when both the inputs are on, okay, or high. So if A is equal to 1, B is equal to 1, so therefore the A and B produces a high output, that is 1. This is the truth table of AND gate. See, one more, that is OR gate. OR gate. See, this is another logic gate. See the circuit symbol of OR gate. See, this is OR gate. This is output Y. See, an OR gate has two or more inputs. This is input A, this is input B. This is the Boolean expression Y equal to A or B. See, it can be read as A or B. See the truth table of OR gate. See, OR gate has two inputs. See, these are two inputs A, B, and this is output Y. Y equal to A or B. See, for the 0, 0 input, you will get 0 output. For 0, 1 input, we will get 1 output. For 1, 0 input, we will get 1 output. And finally, for 1, 1 input, we will get 1 input. So, the OR gate produces high outputs if it's one of its input is high, okay, or in other words, the OR gate will be in high state or on state if one of its inputs are high. So, which is in off state if both the inputs are in off state. So, these are the basic logic gates. So, NOT gate, AND gate, OR gate. See, NOT gate produces the invert of the input. AND gate will be in ON state when both of its inputs are ON state. OR gate produces the ON state or high value if one of its inputs are high. Okay, therefore, these are the basic building blocks of digital electronics. See, the one more logic gates, that is the NAND gate. See the next digital logic gate, NAND gate. See, NAND, NAND gate. See, AND gate. See, this is AND gate followed by a NOT gate. See, this gate is called the NAND gate. See the circuit symbol of a NAND gate. See, this is the negation of AND gate. See, we will get the reverse output of AND gate. See, a NAND gate has two inputs or many inputs. See, this is input A, this is input B, and this is output Y. The Boolean expression for this is A and B whole bar. Okay, so this is the NAND gate. See the truth table of a NAND gate. See, this is the truth table for NAND gate. This is A, B, this is output A and B whole bar. See, suppose for the low inputs, if both the inputs are low, that is 0, 0 input, we will get 0 in case of AND gate. See, here the AND gate followed by a NOT gate. When this 0, 0 input to the AND gate produces 0 output, whereas in case of NAND gate, it produces 1. Okay. See, for the next inputs, 0, 1 input. See, in case of AND gate, 0, 1 produces 0, but here it produces 1. Similarly, for the next 1, 0 inputs, it produces again output 1. And finally, for 1, 1 input, it produces 1 in case of AND gate, but here it produces 0 output. See, now one more digital logic gate, that is NOR gate. See the fifth one, NOR gate. NOR gate is OR gate followed by NOT gate. This is called the NOR gate. Okay. See this NOR gate. See the circuit symbol of NOR gate. See, this is OR gate. OR gate inverted using the NOT gate. So, OR gate followed by the NOT gate gives the NOR gate. See, NOR gate, a NOR gate has two or more inputs. See, these are the two inputs, A and B, and Y is the output. Y equal to A or B whole bar. See, this is the NOR gate. See the truth table of a NOR gate. See, this is the input A, input A, input B, output Y equal to A or B whole bar. See, for 0, 0 input, see, for 0, 0 input for the OR gate, we will get one output. See, for the 0, 0 input for an OR gate, we will get 0 output, but here we will get one output. And next inputs, 0, 1 input. See, in case of OR gate, for 0, 1 input, we will get one output, but here we will get 0 output. For 0, 1 input, we will get again 0 output. And finally, for 1, 1 input, 1, 1 input, we will get again 0 output. See, the NOR gate is the inverter of OR gate. See, which inverts the OR gate? See, OR gate followed by NOT gate is called the NOR gate. See, NOR gate is in ON state when both of its inputs are in OFF state. See, here in NAND gate, the NAND gate is in OFF state when both of its inputs are in OFF state. See, using these digital logic gates, we can construct an electronic circuit known as integrated circuit. See, these NAND gate and NOR gate are known as universal gates, since using NAND gates and NOR gate, we can realize any basic logic gates like NOT gate, AND gate or OR gate. Okay. So, these logic gates, NAND gate and NOR gate, are called universal gates. See, using these logic gates, nowadays we can construct fabricate electronic circuit on a single semiconductor block known as the integrated circuit. See, integrated circuits. In short, these are called ICs. These are called ICs. See, there are so many conventional methods to fabricate an electronic circuit using resistor, capacitor, diodes, etc. But nowadays, the widely used technology is the fabricating these active and passive elements on a single semiconductor block known as the chip. The widely used method of fabricating the integrated circuits is the monolithic integrated circuits. See, monolithic integrated circuits. See, this monolithic integrated circuits. Monolithic integrated circuits means, monolithic means, mono means single, lithic means stone. On a single silicon stone, a large number of various electronic elements can be formed on a single chip known as the integrated circuit. Okay. See, depending on the type of input signal. These integrated circuits are of two types, analog integrated circuits and digital electronic integrated circuits. See, in case of digital integrated circuits, again we have so many types, depending on our requirement. That is, small scale integrated circuits, large scale integrated circuits, medium scale integrated circuit, and very large scale integrated circuits. See, very large scale integrated circuit uses about 1000 logic gates. So using logic gates, we can construct the digital electronic circuits. Okay. See, let us discuss the important questions on semiconductor electronics. See, the first question is the classification of solids on the basis of band theory of solids, and then intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductors. See, what are intrinsic semiconductor and what are extrinsic semiconductors, and difference between intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductors. Next one is n-type and p-type semiconductor. See, what is n-type semiconductor and what are the impurity atoms used for doping the n-type semiconductor and p-type semiconductor, and distinguish between n-type and p-type semiconductors. So the next one is the formation of p-n junction diode. See, explain how a p-n junction diode is formed. And the next one is half wave and full wave rectifier. See, what is a half wave rectifier, and explain the working of a half wave rectifier with the input and output waveform. Similarly, in case of the full wave rectifier, the question will be like this: what is a full wave rectifier? Explain the working of a full wave rectifier with input and output waveforms. And the next one is Zener diode. See, what is a Zener diode, and explain how a Zener diode acts as a voltage regulator. It's an important question, the Zener diode. Okay, next one is photodiode, LED and solar cell. See, and finally, draw the circuit symbol of NOT gate, AND gate, OR gate with their truth tables. So it will be for 1 or 2 marks. Draw the circuit symbol of NOT gate and draw the truth table of AND gate and NOT gate or OR gate. And similarly, NAND gate and NOR gate. Okay. So draw the circuit symbols of NAND gate and NOR gate along with their truth tables.